Take it away.
Okay, next slide. Okay, there we go. A little bit of the introduction about who I am. I want to say that if you're a Christian and you feel a personal relationship with Jesus, I was there. And my goal tonight is to let you know there's a way out if you want to get out and why you should get out. So basically, I was raised as a Roman Catholic. During the middle school years, I think it was, I was confirmed as a Roman Catholic. Through college, in college, I met a born-again Christian. I became a born-again evangelical Christian. You're probably familiar with the Four Spiritual Laws book by Campus Crusade for Christ. I memorized that and like to preach the gospel to people. And since I got a bachelor's degree in electronics, I've been working in the computer industry. While I was doing that, I was learning more about evangelism and apologetics. So for 25 years, I was growing in the faith, even started a nonprofit 501c3 ministry to preach the gospel on TV and the internet, working part-time on a master's in ministry degree and got that. So in 2007, I got my degree, and in 2009, I became an atheist because I found that the atheists have better arguments. And I'm now active in atheist groups and secular groups such as Portland or Sunday Assembly Portland and Center for Philosophical Naturalism is a group that I run to help people discuss and talk about how to live a life in a naturalistic worldview. Next slide. So what's the best evidence for God? I think it's unspoken, and that is that you feel this personal relationship with God. Next slide. There's a story, for example, that goes on the internet where basically a person is eating an apple and they ask the other person, the Christian asks the atheist or the non-believer. It's a complicated story, but I'm just going to summarize it and change it a little bit. The Christian asks the non-believer, hey, tell me, that apple I ate, was it sweet or sour? And he goes, I haven't tasted your apple, I don't know. And he says, neither, sir, have you tasted my Jesus. And, you know, it says, have you tasted Jesus? Have you, you know, do you have a personal relationship with him? So that's supposed to be a compelling argument. So this is what I'm going to be talking about tonight. Next slide. So William Lane Craig, he's one of the preeminent Christian debaters. He's got a philosophy degree and debates all the famous atheists. And this is, I'm going to give a couple quotes from him. One is, he basically says that if there's a conflict that arises between the witness of the Holy Spirit, which is the feelings you get about being, you know, from the Holy Spirit, and your beliefs based on argument and evidence, then it must be the former which must take precedence over the latter. In other words, you have to take precedence on your feelings over evidence. And so, next slide. Another thing he says is that it's the self-authenticating witness of the Holy Spirit that gives us the fundamental knowledge of Christianity's truth. The only role left for argument and evidence to play is a subsidiary role. In other words, primarily, your truth is derived by the witness of the Holy Spirit. In other words, your feeling that you have with God. And the evidence and all that, that's just, he says, that's just secondary. That's just what I use to, you know, talk about God to non-believers, but that's not my primary thing. Next slide. So after I left the faith, I learned more about logical thinking and philosophy, and one of these is called logical fallacies, and there's a whole bunch of logical fallacies. These explain how your logic goes off the rail and can lead you to false conclusions. Next slide. One of them is called the appeal to emotion, and basically it says the problem here is when emotion is used as a logical argument, and what I want to say is that's what I think this is a form of I think it's a logical fallacy to say follow your feelings, because your feelings cannot determine truth. Next slide. One example that is really clear is we all know probably here, none of us are Mormons probably, we all know Joseph Smith was a false prophet. We all know the Book of Mormon is, you know, nothing but fiction. We all know that. And yet they say if you pray to God, this is how you know the Book of Mormon is true. Pray to God and he'll give you a burning in the bosom if it's true. I met with Mormons a while back. How many? Okay. I did this. I got the burning in the bosom, and I was a Mormon for like 3 seconds because I realized it was not true. I mean, logically. Okay, let's go to the very end. Next slide. Next slide. Next slide. And I just want to say that this is Ryan Bell. He's one of these pastors that left the faith, and he says, I want to have a personal relationship with reality instead of a personal relationship with Jesus. So I'll leave it with that, and hopefully we're all on the same page. We all want to seek truth, and that's our common ground.
Okay, so 3 minutes response from the Christians.